I am Anu Ballarpure, working as project engineer in Rewari Engineering, India. Very first, I am thankful to organizer and committee members for giving opportunity to present my work. Here, I am presenting my work entitled A Design Methodology of Rope Tension Meter Used for Lift Automatic Door Assembly. Following are the contents of today's presentation. Motivation of the work, where I will explain the purpose of the work. Then introduction to auto door assembly and role of rope tension, where I will explain the basic terminology used in the paper. Then experimental work. In that section, I will explain the building blocks of the experiments. Then calibration setup and results, where I will explain various calibration setups and their results. And then conclusion. In the elevator system, it was observed that most of the callback is due to door mechanism. While investigation, door mechanism, service engineer checked the various components of the door mechanism as per the reported problem. While checking, he will also check the rope tension of the auto door assembly. But the question is, how service guard checked the rope tension? How does he determine the rope tension? And it is observed that most of the service engineer determine the rope tension just by feel, that is by pulling the rope. And on that basis, the service engineer decides whether rope tension is proper or need to tighten. But the rope tension determined by this procedure is vary by person to person. And it requires experienced engineer. And this is the motivation behind the development of rope tension measurement tool. And this paper explains design's methodology of the measurement tool. While designing simple design procedure and low cost off the shelf components were used, so that the people with little technical background should develop this measurement tool in-house. First, I explain little bit information about the auto door mechanism and its components. Typical lift auto door mechanism consists of car door assembly and landing door assembly, in which car door assembly is an active driving component, that is motor and its driving unit connected to car assembly, and according to instruction given by control panel, this take action. Whereas landing door assembly is a passive driven component, and with the help of coupler skids, it is coupled with car door assembly. Figure shows the different components of the auto door assembly, such as car frame, hanger, main roller, supporting track, up thrust roller, door panel, etc. In the case of center opening mechanism, the door panels moves in opposite direction during operation. The linkage between the door panel is established through a simple roping system of two pulleys. The smooth movement of the door panels can be obtained by maintaining the required tension in the rope. Over time, during normal usage, the rope tension needs to be readjusted. As previously explained, in most of the cases, service engineer determine it by the feel. The alternative to this method is the usage of measurement tool. Various type of analog and digital rope tension meters are available in the market, but these measurement tools are not specifically designed for lift door operators. To provide an alternative low-cost solution, we are presenting a low-cost open-source design of a rope tension meter, which is specifically designed for lift automatic door assembly. Experimental setup. Figure shows the building block of the system, which includes sensor unit, signal conditioning and digitization unit, processing unit and a touch screen. Except sensor unit, all other units are designed using readily available off-the-shelf components. Sensor unit having two important parts. One is load cell, which is readily available in market, and the mechanical structure, which is designed in our workshop. The sensor unit is designed such that the load cell is fitted within a custom designed mechanical structure. And the main purpose of the mechanical structure is to provide housing for load cell and to transfer the tension from rope to the load cell. Figure depicts the sensor unit and also shows the various parts of the sensor unit, such as U-groove block, hand screw, two wheels, rope, stopper, linkage clamp, etc. Other part of the system is developed with the help of readily available components, such as signal conditioning and digitization unit is developed with the help of HX711 module, which is dedicatedly used for vaning mechanism. It has inbuilt analog amplifier with programmable gain array and 24-bit ADC. Then processing unit, Arduino Uno microcontroller board. Then touch screen, which is act as a user interface. To measure the rope tension of the rope of the auto door assembly, one need to connect the sensor unit as shown in figure. The sensor unit fitted such that the two wheel inside the unit helps to guide the rope to take a proper position inside the U-groove clamp. Then need to move the U-groove clamp by tightening the hand screw until its movement is stopped by the stopper. The linkage clamp connected to the U-groove block and the shaft of the load cell transfer the rope tension from rope to the load cell. The resultant output of the load cell is fed to the electronic circuitry to process and provide the output data in required format. To develop final prototype, we have carried out different testing and calibration process, and for that we develop various calibration setup in our workshop. Broadly, we have categorized the experiment in three different parts. First one is calibration of load cell for testing of load cell for linear behavior. Second one is sensor unit calibration to test the behavior of sensor unit. And finally, we take a trial of sensor unit on actual setup. In next upcoming slides, I can explain the experimental setup and its results. Load cell calibration setup. The objective of this setup is to verify the linearity of the load cell. For that, very simple calibration setup is designed with the help of aluminum extrusion. Here, the shaft of the load cell is directly loaded with the different calibrated dead weights and relative readings are recorded. The readings of the calibration setup are shown in the plot, where x-axis represents the weights and y-axis represent the raw ADC counts. The triangle symbol represents output of load cell for various weight, and the red circle symbol represents calculated ADC counts on the basis of manufacturer datasheet. From graph, expected linear trend of the load cell with maximum deviation of 1.5% with respect to data provided by manufacturer is observed. Sensor unit calibration. Load cell calibration setup validates the load cell linearity, but in that setup, the load cell is directly loaded with the applied load without any intermediate medium. But in actual measurement tool, the load cell is fitted within the mechanical structure and the tension is transferred with the help of linkage clamp. Because of that, it is necessary to calibrate the whole unit for various weights. And for that, we have developed this calibration setup, where sensor unit is clamped on the rope and rope is loaded with the different calibrated dead weights. The output readings are noted. graph for applied drop tension versus output drop ADC count is plotted. In this plot, x-axis represents the drop tension and y-axis represents the raw ADC count. The red color circle represents output ADC counts for applied drop tension. The blue line represents the linear trend line. The data highlighted in figure shows the linear response of the sensor unit, similar to the linear response trend seen in load cell calibration section. However, as expected, due to mechanical structure and indirect loading of the load cell, attenuation effect occurs in the sensor unit readings compared to the bare load cell response. For example, if we consider when the load cell is directly loaded with the 150 Newton, the output is 1.3 × 10⁵ ADC counts. And when the load cell is indirectly loaded with the help of linkage clamp and mechanical structure, the output decreases such that ADC count recorded are 4 × 10⁵. Such lower bound values of sensor unit highlights the mechanical structure cause attenuation effect on a load cell. And to find out this attenuation effect is the main purpose of this experiment. The output of this experiment is used to calculate the rope tension in actual setup. After validating and calculating the response of sensor unit, the sensor unit is tested on particular type of auto door mechanism. The sensor unit fitted as explained earlier. While calibrating the sensor unit, the rope tension is varies by using various dead weight. But in auto door mechanism, the rope tension is varies by using rope tension adjustment nut, which is shown in figure. The output results are noted and the output ADC counts against the various nut positions are plotted. Here, the x-axis represents the position of rope tension adjustment nut and y-axis represents the output ADC count. To validate the results, tests are performed repeatedly. 5 different tests are shown in plot, whereas blue round symbol represent test 1, red squares represent test 2, black triangle represent test 3, green circle represent test 4, and sky blue square represent test 5. All the tests exhibit the linear trend, that is, as you increase the rope tension by tightening the nut, the corresponding ADC count increases. At some nut position, ADC counts are different, and that is human error occurred by adjusting the nut position. By comparing output ADC count in sensor unit calibration setup and this setup, the ADC count is determined in the form of rope tension in Newton. And by using the same reading, rope tension against various nut position is plotted in next slide. Here, x-axis represents nut position and y-axis represents rope tension in Newton. The graph is plotted using the readings of previous plots. The difference is here, y-axis represents the rope tension instead of the raw ADC counts. The conclusion is the design, prototype, and methodology of rope tension meter is specifically designed for measurement of rope tension of auto door assembly. Various experiments are performed to calibrate and validate the output of rotation meter. The results exhibits and confirms the repeatability and easy to use operation of rotation meter. With these points, I would like to conclude my presentation. I would like to acknowledge my team members for their support and encourage me for this work. References. These are the references used to carry out the work. Thanks to all.